Hello, everyone. Welcome to another session. I have got two fantastic guests with me. Yes, two guests, pretty rare here for becoming a pharmacy badass. If you don't know me, I am Dr. Lisa Faast, CEO and founder of Diversify RX. And if you haven't been following me, I'm going to tell you a little secret about myself is I am a data nerd, like a straight up number loving nerd, love spreadsheets, love Excel. And so when I met our guests today, I immediately fell in love with these guys and their software. So I've got AJ and Arson from Ugo RX, which is a software company that lives in data, which is why I love them so much. So welcome, guys. Welcome to the show. I'm excited to introduce our tribe of amazing pharmacy owners to you guys, because I see the value in data and analyzing your own data and using that to make better decisions and to improve your pharmacy. So you guys have a really interesting kind of backstory. So whichever one of you want to go first, AJ or Arson, feel free to jump on in, but tell us kind of how this whole thing got started. Like where did pharmacists and software like come in for a marriage?
Sure. First of all, thank you guys so much. Such a pleasure to be on, Lisa. Thank you so much for having us. Actually, my backstory is not as amazingly interesting as Arson, so I'll get myself out of the way, because I came from the world of real estate, private equity, business finance major, stuff like that. So business, numbers, analytics, data, Excel was my best friend. I'm a spreadsheet geek. So Arson and I had the astute pleasure of being close friends for almost 20 years now. And I owe it to him as to how I got involved in this whole thing. And his backstory is brilliant as to how it all came about with the whole thing of Ugo. So Arson, I'll let you kind of tell the crowd where you come from.
Well, hi, everybody. Thank you again, Lisa, for having us. I'll definitely get into it. I've been in the industry for 12 years now, since 2010. Started from the bottom, with a small repackaging pharmacy company out of Glendale, California. And I moved myself up, and I knew it was a new language while my wife was attending pharmacy school over at USC. So I knew this was a career that I wanted to get into. So I made a shift from the finance side and went into the health side of things, and especially pharmacy. So I started with a little boutique pharmacy out of Glendale that was doing repackaging, started learning the ABCs of NDCs and AWPs and what they meant, and what, you know, I had no clue when I first started. So that was a lot of fun and then challenging. As I just visited different clinics, it was an in-office dispensing pharmacy that, repackaged and sent it to a clinic. So as I did that, I went into wholesaling. Did a little bit of wholesaling sales and consulting as well. And in 2014, opened up our first pharmacy. Then that led to our second pharmacy in 2015 and our third one in 2019. I did numerous different things. We did retail pharmacy, we did work comp pharmacy, and we also did mail order pharmacy. Of course, the industry took a huge sort of shift in, I would say, about 2017 and 18. And that's when I knew I needed AJ. That's when I knew I needed to bring AJ in so we could try to figure this out as things were getting difficult, the regulations, reimbursement cuts. So as AJ came in, we sat there, numerous hours trying to break down Excel and try to figure out all the different NDCs. And of course, I needed to sort of educate AJ on what AWP means and what NDCs mean and why is this manufacturer reimbursing this much, what's an alternative, so on and so on. But it was a lot of fun. It was an experience. As we sat there, again, dissecting numbers and doing a lot of analytics, we figured that we should create a system for ourselves. And I know AJ will get into more on how everything just started. But that's when Ugo was born, just putting all the experiences that we had and into this platform that could help other independent pharmacy owners to get through it. I knew we were nervous when we first opened up. We had no idea. Again, just a lot of challenges. And I'm sure every other pharmacy owner out there is faced with these challenges. And they're looking for answers. They're looking for people. And we did the same as well. That's why we want to put this platform into all in one place so we could go, help other independent owners. So I'll
Well, I love the origin story where it really was born out of the need as you as a pharmacy owner, like you were in this looking at this data. I'm right there with you. I can spend hours in a spreadsheet. I love it. But we all know that pharmacy owners don't have time to do that. And most hate it. Most don't love it. Most aren't weird like us. And so they need an easy to use platform. And so really what you learned is like, oh my gosh, this information helped me improve my pharmacy. So what kind of happened in your own pharmacy from spending time and analyzing the data and building it into the software? Like what changes did you see in your pharmacy before you kind of started launching it to others?
You want me to take that, Ars?
Yes, I do.
So when we started dissecting the analytics, what we quickly realized, first of all, was what was good business, what was bad business. We learned where we were losing money. And that was something that, you know, in the thick of it, in the day-to-day of it, especially when you're just struggling through the day-to-day, you're not paying attention. You're kind of just thankful for every prescription that comes in, so to say. And, you know, we had like two CVSs, one block from us. So we were sandwiched, which was hilarious at the time. But yeah, we started learning what made sense and what didn't make sense. You know, what wholesalers we should look at, which ones we shouldn't look at. You know, what the craziest thing for me, at least not coming from the industry, was how two brands of the same medication can pay totally different, you know, for the same it was really boggling to me. So all the nuances and those little intricacies that added to profitability or loss of revenue was what we discovered right off the bat, you know, looking at what group numbers meant. I mean, I didn't even understand that you could have two patients walk in, both of them, husband and wife with silver script, but one's with a different health plan and another health plan, same drugs, same everything, pays different. And so we started to really kind of draw the lines between, you know, what manufacturer maybe went well with what NDC, you know, PBM and blah, blah, blah. And so that was what we started to dissect right away. So we made some very, very, very quick changes that shockingly to us, because we didn't think it was going to be that aggressive, but it made a massive change to our profitability, just simple tweaks. And that was what really kind of kickstarted us by going, we're sitting on something that's so amazing. Everyone else is suffering too. We got to put this out to everybody. We originally built Ugo selfishly for ourselves to use. And then we saw how powerful it was. And we realized we got to protect the ecosystem of independent pharmacy. We have to.
No, so absolutely. You know, I am on a mission to save independent pharmacy, and I can't do that alone. And that's why I love connecting with people like you guys that are, I mean, very like-minded, not only just in your guys' mission to help independent pharmacy owners, but the way that your pricing model is and the way that, you know, just the way that you're approaching the business is very similar how we're doing it with Diversify. It's kind of like we're not in this to, you know, retire rich on an island. We're here really to just, you know, but cover the costs, cover the basics. You know, yes, we have to put food on our table, but it is about the ultimate being able to help independent pharmacies and keeping them in business longer, which means ultimately they have to make a profit. I say all the time, profit is not a four-letter word. It is not a bad thing to make a profit. Sure, you could do bad things and make a profit, but that is not the only way. There's millions of ways to make a very good profit, but this is where it is. Your data is so, so valuable. And most pharmacy owners just don't have the time and they don't have the skill set to know how to look at the data. And that's where Ugo comes in and basically does all of that heavy lifting for you. Like when you guys were first playing it around with me, I was just amazed. I like every new feature you showed me, I was like, oh, that's my favorite one. You know, that's my favorite one. Like, oh, I love that. And it's just rich and it's your own data, like your own data. Yes, you can pull some things in from your guys's network of pharmacy owners, which I think is up around 100 pharmacy owners now, give or take something like that. But your own data sitting in your pharmacy is so valuable. I think of what you said, what makes sense and what doesn't make sense. And I was analyzing data in my own pharmacy many, many years ago. It was how I first came up with my Accutane program. I was sitting in my office one day looking at all of those negative margin reports that we so commonly look at. And I figured, you know, I have money in the bank. I must be doing something right. I must be making money somewhere. Let's go figure out where I'm making money. And I actually had to call my PMS software and they had to create custom reports. Nobody had ever asked what am I making money on before? Like, I, you know, and that's what I figured out. I was making a ton of money on generic Accutane. And so I asked myself, how can I go get more of that business? And that's what spawned my entire Accutane program, which I feel ended up filling probably a majority of the prescriptions for Accutane in Central California for quite a few years that really did really well for us. And I would have never known that if I hadn't taken a look at my data. And so I know how impactful data is to the story of a success or failure of a pharmacy. And so what are you guys seeing now? Now that you're out in the world, you've shared this with pharmacy owners, you have over 100 pharmacy owners, you know, that are signed up, that are using it. What is that feedback that you're getting? What is the impact that they're having in their pharmacies from having access to these analytics?
Sure. I think, you know, Arsen touched on it best after we were doing some analytics with a few of our pharmacies. And the two words that we're hearing over and over and over, which is a massive compliment, is that our platform seems to be very practical and relevant. And, you know, that's the one thing that I think a lot of pharmacy owners, especially even when we owned our pharmacy, data is one thing. But being able to practically apply that data, practically, you know, you could throw KPIs and all these widgets and data at people, but, you know, pharmacy owners didn't go to school for that. It's like drinking water out of a fire hose, and that becomes scary. And that scary becomes the first domino that just ticks them into going, I don't want to see this, you know, hear no evil, see no evil type thing. And they ostrich the situation. And unfortunately it ends up just burying them. But yeah, I mean, what we're hearing from a lot of people, which is the biggest compliment we could have ever received, is that, man, this is really relevant. This is really practical. And that's the coolest thing for us. I mean, as cheesy as it sounds, we are seeing that amongst across all of our pharmacies, that if they're spending an average of about 10 minutes a day for like 3 to 4 days a week, we are seeing a very strong staple of about 10% profit per prescription increase per pharmacy, which has been super amazing. I mean, and that's like within the first 30 days, if they really kind of spend the 10 minutes, which is not too much. But we've gone ballistic really to try to simplify it down, because we realize that people aren't like us. You're right, Lisa, they're not. And if we designed this platform, like in my opinion, a lot of other platforms were designed by tech people and then given to the pharmacy industry to say, hey, use this. And you're telling people what they think, what you think they need, instead of just giving them what they're asking for. So what we've been trying to do is give the community what it's asking for. And hopefully we're achieving that. It seems so. Every day we're adding new people, so we hope so.
No, I think you hit the nail on the head, is that, you know, data analytics isn't new for by any way, shape or form. However, making it practical and easy to use, and like you said, 10 minutes a day can have a dramatic difference to your bottom line, I think is what's new and exciting. And that's why I got so excited when I saw your platform, because I've been living in the data world for a very, very long time, not only my own pharmacy, but I have looked at probably over 1,000 pharmacy spreadsheets. Like, I still like look at spreadsheets and I sort and I, you know, I do all my little Excel magic, you know, my happy place. And there's a difference. There's someone, like you said, KPIs don't matter. And that's why I'm so important. I'm so picky about the KPIs that I talk about, because it has to be actionable. You know, data is great for just data's sake, but for pharmacy owners in particular, you got to give them that immediate like priority step. And that's what I liked about your system, is you can spend just a short amount of time, and it doesn't even have to be the pharmacy owner. It can be the technician, it can be the manager, it can be just, you know, that other person, because it is intuitive. It is easy to use. It's very graphic, you know, very visual, very clickable, you know, it's a very kind of intuitive system that you don't have to have like a, you know, science degree in data in order to understand it, which a lot of these other programs, they're certainly robust and they're certainly informative, but it's just so dang hard to understand unless you're a complete, you know, data scientist. And so I think that's the big difference. So if you're watching this and if you're with the independent pharmacy, I think it is well worth your time to take a demo of Ugo RX. I think you will be amazed just as much as I am. Maybe not as much as I am. I get a little excited about data, but you will be amazed. And I know it's going to have a huge impact to your bottom line. And the other really great thing is I will spoil the surprise and let you know that it is not expensive. As much as I'm talking about it, you might be thinking, holy crap, this is great, Lisa, but can I afford it? I will tell you, I promise you can afford it. And that was the thing that really sealed the deal, is that I knew that these were good guys because they were charging far below what I think the value is. So, you know, get it while you can. I don't know how long that's going to last, but it is definitely very affordable. So guys, so if somebody wants to check out Ugo, figure out what these analytics are, figure out maybe how it can apply to their pharmacy. Like, what are those best next steps for them that they can go about in the process?
Sure. Yeah. Please, if you guys would, check out our website, which is www.ugorx.com. And right in the top right corner, there's a big red button that says request a trial. Please go ahead and click on that. We'd love to do a quick combo with you if you have interest in you know, asking us some questions. We can show you what the platform looks like and how it works. And when you click that request a trial thing, it'll scroll you to the bottom, or you can leave us a message. In that message, just, you know, if you would, note that you can put the words Lisa or something like that. We'd be happy to even give people that reference that some promotional pricing for a few months, since you're coming from your network, Lisa.
That's awesome. Well, thank you guys for that. I always love giving discounts to my people. It's a benefit of them, you know, listening to us and helping spread the good word to all the independent pharmacy owners. And, you know, if we were actually going to be seeing you guys at the Pharmacy Profit Summit in Dallas in August, so people will be able to see and touch and kind of feel the system there. I bet you there's going to be a buzz there about this software, because I know I'm talking about this with my members of Pharmacy Badass University, that this is something that they need to go do. So there's going to be probably quite a few pharmacies there. They're going to be using this in their system. And I can't wait to kind of hear the feedback. You know, they're going to have 4 to 6 months in of time before that. And so I'm really looking forward to kind of those stories, because I know they're going to be good. So thank you so much, guys, for kind of putting this together and putting it in such a useful way, for a very low cost, that really makes it basically highly accessible and highly usable by all pharmacy owners. And so I just appreciate it. I'm glad to have found somebody else on my mission to help save the independent pharmacy industry. And I look forward to seeing you guys in person in just a couple of months.
Likewise. Thank you so much, Lisa.
Thank you so much. All right. Again, Lisa.
Thank you, guys. We will talk soon.
Thanks, guys.